Yeah, we're gonna. I'm gonna try to detach each part here tonight. Let us join in our opening prayer. Almighty God, we ask that you graciously behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, deserted, and crucified. Help us to reflect and consider our part in the crucifixion of our Lord and Savior. Amen. Those who are able, please rise as we join in our opening song.
Oh. tonight, the format is going to be talking about the nails of the cross. And the first nail is the nail of pride. I'll be reading Mark 12, 38 to 40. As he taught, Jesus said, "Watch out for the teachers of the law. They like to walk around in flowing robes and be greeted with respect in the marketplaces and have the most important seats in the synagogues and the places of honor at banquets. They devour widows' houses and for a show make lengthy prayers. These men will be punished most severely."
Let us join together. O God, help us consider our own pride and the word of ease. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our pride hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our pride hurts you.
When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain
the nail of betrayal, Matthew 26, verses 47 through 50. While he was still speaking, Judas came, one of the 12, and with him a great crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign saying, "The one I shall kiss is the man. Seize him." And he came up to Jesus at once and said, "Hail, Master!" And he kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, why are you here?" Then they came up and laid hands on Jesus and seized him. Let us pray. O God, help us consider how we betray others, how we abandon them in their time of need, how we think of ourselves first. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our acts of betrayal hurt us and create walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our betrayal hurts you.
The nail of envy. This is from Matthew 20, verse 20 through 28, a mother's request. Then the mother of Zebedee's sons came to Jesus with her sons and kneeling down asked a favor of him. "What is it you want?" he asked. She said, "Grant that one of these two sons of mine may sit at your right hand and the other at your left in your kingdom." "You don't know what you're asking," Jesus said to them. "Can you drink the cup I am going to drink?" "We can," they answered. Jesus said to them, "You will indeed drink from my cup, but to sit at my right hand or left is not for me to grant. These places belong to those for whom they have been prepared by my Father." When the ten heard about this, they were indignant with the two brothers. Jesus called them together and said, "You know that rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their high officials exercise authority over them. Not so with you. Instead, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wants to be first must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." Let us pray.
O God, help us consider how we envy others, how we desire more than we receive, and seek to influence and rule over others. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our envy hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our envy hurts you.
His hands, his feet.
27, verses 27 to 31 and 39 to 42. Soldiers mock Jesus. Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus into the praetorium and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand. They knelt in front of him and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. They spit on him and took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. After they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. Let us pray. O God, help us consider how we are cruel to others, how we gossip and slander others, and add to the evil that comes upon them. O God, do not let us deceive ourselves. Our cruelty hurts us and creates walls between us and others. O God, we know too that our cruelty hurts you.
That day, well, the soldiers teachers tried to clear the narrow street. But the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary.
This reading is from Luke 23, verses 33 to 46. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him there, along with the criminals, one on his right, the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they divided up his clothes by casting lots. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him. They said, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is God's Messiah, the chosen one." The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar and said, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself. There was a written notice above him which read, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God?" he said. "Since you are under the same sentence, we are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." And he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "Truly, I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." The death of Jesus. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. For the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father! Into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last.
Those who are able, please rise. As we sing this, if you feel led to come forward, to touch a cross, to pick up a nail, a spike, feel free to do so during this closing song. And also, I was remiss in the beginning to say that Diana Reedy took ill and was unable to be here. Should have said that in the beginning. Let us join in this song, and I ask then that we lead in silence.
Were you there when they crucified Sometimes Were you